And I did some digging and I found out that that state's own governor is Hispanic and she says she is against it. She says this law makes it easier for drug smugglers to travel around the country if they have a license. And it's worth pointing out that Chicago is now one of the country's main hubs for heroin distribution. That the suspect walked right into this Von Maur store and then started charging thousands of dollars of merchandise to people like you. Now, let me explain how police say he did this. I'm using my Sam's card to show you. But police say that he was actually making his own credit cards and then scratching off the magnetic strip on the back. That way, the employees could not just swipe it. They had to physically key in the numbers. Well, those numbers were actually to other people's bank accounts. This is a $33 million project, a whole lot of money. I have a yardstick with me because I want to show you. They are going to be raising Lenore K. Sullivan Boulevard 2.5 feet. Now, for that much money, 30 inches sure doesn't look like a lot, but the people I talk to say this will make a huge difference in getting this street out of the flood area. And a conversation that unfolded right here on Twitter quickly turned to another emerging technology here, drones. Twitter only accepts 140 characters, so your question has to be very concise. Think about 20 words or so. And Emily, we are joining you from Lenore K. Sullivan Boulevard. We are next to the Mississippi River and the grand staircase leading up to the arch. And we are here today because there are some big changes happening. And you might notice that I have a yardstick in my hand. I want to explain just what's going to happen. There's going to be a groundbreaking ceremony on this road, and it's going to kick off a $33 million two-year effort to raise this road 2.5 feet. 30 inches. Now I want to go ahead and show you some video of what the street looks like in the daytime. It is a gathering place for people to come to enjoy the arch, to look out at the river, and even to hang out by some food trucks. But today is going to be a gathering place for some really big names. Think Mayor Francis Slay, County Executive Charlie Dooley, and even the Governor of Missouri, Jay Nixon. Those with the group overseeing this part of the entire arch overhaul say that the money up front will receive a huge return on investment, an estimated $65 million a year.
So for the investment of the $10 million from Great Rivers Greenway District, we've been able to leverage that against $33 million. So we've got significant federal transportation grants. So we're really getting a return for $2 for every one that the taxpayers are putting into the project.
Now, this entire City Arch River project is costing an estimated $400 million, and half of that money is actually from private donations. But there is a part of this project that is about 6 months behind schedule. I'll explain what that is coming up in my next report at 6:20. Reporting from the riverfront, Laura Hediger, News 4. And I want you to think about cell phones and police cruisers for just a second. Now, these are two older forms of technology that police still use to keep you safe. They still work very well, but this morning we are focusing on new technology. Think Twitter here and also drones. Now, I hope that got your attention. You're going to want to stick around for my full report. I'll be piecing together the old technology with the new technology coming up at 5:30.
News 4's Laura Hediger continues to follow Illinois politics for us. And Laura, some people have had today's date circled on the calendar for months.
Yeah, Andre, 4 months. Governor Quinn signed this into law back in January, so undocumented workers have actually been waiting for 10 months. And today is now the first day that they can begin making an appointments to apply for these temporary driver's licenses. To get a license ahead of the official January rollout, undocumented workers must make an appointment by calling either the number on your screen or logging on to www.cyberdriveillinois.com. Then, at the earliest, those meeting all the requirements will be able to get a license in Springfield or Chicago on December 3rd. Illinois is one of just 6 states that have this program, and I called a senator yesterday to get an idea of why some say this bill will help public safety. Those supporting it say that now every driver in Illinois will have insurance, but then there are plenty of others who say it will actually hurt public safety. That senator pointed me to New Mexico. It's one of the 6 states who have this, and I did some digging and I found out that that state's own governor is Hispanic, and she says she is against it. She says this law makes it easier for drug smugglers to travel around the country if they have a license. And it's worth pointing out that Chicago is now one of the country's main hubs for heroin distribution. This is a story News 4 will continue to follow for you. Laura Hediger, News 4. A very hot topic, both locally and nationally. So it's no wonder after the chief received so many questions about drones that he came out and made a public pledge to all of you. Whoops. That's what happens with emerging technology. Your hand hits something and it goes away. But the pledge he made to all of you is that drones will be used only, quote, responsibly and after a continued public dialogue. And of course, this is a story that News 4 will continue to follow for all of you. Reporting live from South Patrol, Laura Hediger, News 4.
Laura, don't worry. We got the point. And good job keeping on top of that issue for us. Thank you.